Welcome! Whether you are working on your first piece of art in Desmos, or looking to take the next step in your math art journey, adding animation is another powerful way to bring your graphs to life. To start exploring animation strategies, we will look at a few delightful art submissions from previous years, starting with this graph titled Perseverance Mars Rover. On first look at this graph, you can already see the really great detail and fun use of color. However, what helps take this graph to the next level is that note in the expression list. Start this slider to begin the animation. This represents one of the most efficient ways to add animation to your graph, by using sliders. You probably have seen sliders in Desmos before. Have you ever typed a free variable into an expression, like the b in y equals x plus b, and been prompted to add slider? In our Mars Rover graph, all the animation is controlled by the slider on the variable s. We can look throughout the graph and see how all the moving components reference this one variable. The spokes of the rover wheels are formed by lines whose slopes are defined by the angle s, and the polygons forming the surface of the planet have coordinates that rotate relative to the value of s. To see how the slider s is defined, click on either of the values at the ends of the slider bar and note how the upper and lower bounds of s have been set to 0 and 30 pi. If a step input was used, the values would be limited to fixed interval steps counting up from the lower bound. But this graph doesn't use a step, giving it a nice smooth animation effect. Next to every slider is a play button to animate through all of the slider values. Beneath the play button is an animation properties button that opens an animation mode menu. Here, you can choose to loop forwards and backwards, repeat in one direction, play once, or play indefinitely. The speed button allows you to speed up or slow down your animation. In this graph, the desired visual effect was to have this animation repeat in one direction at a slower speed of 0.15 times. To take our variable animations to the next level, another strategy is to use the ticker to specify an action that will run repeatedly at a specified interval. To explore this, we will take a look at last year's submission, Penguin on Ice, with its adorable animated sliding penguin. Similar to the Mars Rover, the animation of this graph is controlled by a single variable, in this case, real time. However, instead of utilizing the play button to set this variable moving, the value is modified using the ticker. To get started with the ticker, make sure actions are enabled in your account settings under the Advanced tab. To add a ticker, click the Add Item button in the top left of the expression panel. In the Run section, we will specify an action. If we want an action that increases the value of real time by 0.1, we can write real time followed by the right arrow symbol, which can be typed using the subtraction symbol, followed by a greater than sign, and then realtime plus 0.1. Optionally, you can set the duration in milliseconds, ms, for the time interval between ticks. For example, if we type 1 and then click the icon to start running the ticker, it will increase realtime by 0.1 every millisecond. In this graph, the artist increased realtime by dt over 1000. In the ticker, you can use this special variable dt to represent the actual time elapsed since the last tick, measured in milliseconds. So this notation is a great strategy to use if you want your variable to change based on the actual number of seconds elapsed over time. There are so many other brilliant strategies at work in these beautiful creations. We can't wait to see how you will use some of these techniques to bring your next graph to life.